or something like that. substances, and that's kind of where psychedelic rock came from. And these artists were just writing these very wild songs in their time, and it just, the elements of it were kind of either very funky, like guitar, and a lot of layers to their music, and a lot of different sounds combining together, and very hypnotizing vocals, I guess you would say. Spanning out my music taste, because before that, before really like 2 to 3 years ago, I only listened to rap, and that is so embarrassing for me, because there's still people I know that will only listen to rap, and that's it, and I don't understand that, because there is so much music to listen to, and you are limiting yourself to one genre. Granted, it won't, you may not just right now, but that's just what you think. I mean, you just have to get used to expanding your taste, I guess. Yeah, I was one of those people, and I would just listen to like Logic and Chance, but then I think one time I was in the car, and on the radio I was just flipping through channels, and on 5, and I listened since the movie Stand By Me. So I just listened to that song, added it to my playlist, which is probably the first song of a different genre than rap. It's just all rap, and then Stand By Me. It was really weird, but... And then after that, I really just went crazy. I mean, I was mainly looking for stuff in the 50s. And then after the 50s, I expanded to the 60s. And then after that, I kind of looked into more stuff from the 80s. I kind of skipped the 70s. I mean, I haven't really gotten into them yet, but I really plan on it. But, and then just through all different time periods, I mean, I even have some songs from the 30s on my playlist. Fats Waller, he's a great piano player, but also a great singer. I think I like him singing better. Like Ain't Misbehaving by Fats Waller. If you have never heard of that, definitely check it out. I think that's a good thing for everyone. And from that time, I created a playlist with just my name, Logan. And it encompasses all the different genres and all new music that I was hearing and I really liked. And that's why I have like 1,000 to 2,000 songs in there. And it starts off with like all rap, and as the time goes on, it gets so like weird, because it just gets so like gets so filled with random songs from way different sounds. So I can't really shuffle play that playlist anymore, because it just sounds like gibberish. Like I'll be listening to small song, and the next song will be like some 30s jazz music, so I can't really listen to that. So I mean, I like to listen to the same style of song at the one time. But yeah, those are basically some of my playlists that I really enjoy to listen to. And then after those playlists, I made this playlist one like April, a couple years ago. Because I was so excited for summer, so I made a playlist titled Summer, and it would have all these very like bright and happy sounding songs. And I thought I was a genius, because I like to like go outside and just listen to songs. But previous to that, I just listened to my Logan playlist, and it was just all like I said, all these different genres that did not fit with each other. So I thought, hey, maybe I should make a playlist dedicated to summer. So I made this playlist, and it is one of my favorite playlists ever, because I spent my whole summer listening to this album, or not album, playlist of very upbeat and happy songs to listen to in the sunshine. As I went on that summer, I also expanded my taste by looking for more upbeat songs, and I think it's really helped me in all aspects. I think music is so important, which is crazy to think about, because it's just sounds put together by someone else that has such a crazy effect on you. What I'm doing right now, that's crazy, right? Like, and it's also crazy how only so many people have this ability to listen to anything. Like, some people are deaf. I feel so sorry for the people who are deaf, because I don't know how I'd live without music. I mean, it's really just such a good thing to either cheer you up, or just kind of sulk in sadness, or any mood you're feeling. I bet there's a song for that, you know? And that's why I love it so much. You can just, it really brings out your emotions, I guess. It kind of magnifies whatever you're feeling by like 100. How we prefer certain songs over others. That's another thing I don't. series to have where I reviewed music albums or songs.